Like Airbnb, Planet Fitness is benefiting from investor optimism for a big rebound next year. The company's shares are hovering near pre-pandemic levels, despite the threat of more gym closures as COVID numbers worsen in the US. The CEO is Chris Rondeau. He joins me now from Hampton in New Hampshire. Chris, it is good to have you with us. This is interesting that your stock, and I'm not, we're not a stock program per se, but your stock seems to suggest the market likes the environment, but clearly more closures and a difficult Q1 is ahead.
Sure, right. Yeah. I mean, I think thanks for having me on, Richard. You know, I think what the investors are really seeing in the market is saying that, you know, it, granted we're in a difficult time right now, and this year has been very difficult, but we've weathered the storm really well. We still have 2,100 stores. We had no closures because of COVID. And coming out of COVID, I believe strongly, and I think the world does, is that people will pay closer attention to their health coming out of this. So the brighter side of the tailwind of this industry is that people pay more attention to health, getting healthy. So once we get through this, gyms are going to be the place to go.
There is a huge discrepancy between reality and perception. The perception is that the gyms are all a hotbed of bio disaster and that COVID's rampant and everybody's hot and sweating and breathing all over each other. Now, that's not true, but nor is it true that it's a risk-free environment, because you do have people breathing hard, even if it's into a mask, in a closed environment.
Sure. I mean, you've heard of, there's no risk-free environment. Any place has really got some risk of level. You know, interesting study came out of the UK of their track and trace app, and they track and trace their you know, some of their people here in the citizens of the UK, and they tracked the most likely exposure was the two supermarkets at 18%. Second was secondary schools and primary schools at 10 to 12%. Gyms were at 1.1%. That's it. And we've, Planet Fitness, since May reopening, we've had over 100 million workouts and have had no breakouts or contractions within the facility, and the exposure rate is less than 1 per 100,000 workouts. It's like 0.8% of a percent. So we proved we can operate safely, and it's something that's good for your health. Obesity, diabetes, heart disease, lung disease, which when you look at COVID, that's what's affecting the most. So to close a gym is counterproductive.
I freely admit that I'm a gymaholic, although I sort of fell dangerously off during COVID, and I've got a few pounds here that need to be dealt with. But, Chris, you know, what worries me when I'm back in the gym is I see people slacking off in terms of cleaning equipment. I see people not being rigorous. A complacency is setting back in.
Yeah, I mean, I take pride in Planet Fitness's. Even before COVID, we were meticulously clean. And the etiquette of our members is, I'd say, second to none, where members, even before COVID, were cleaning equipment after every use. We have cleaning stations throughout the facility with sanitization spray that they can use to clean the equipment. And it happened to be an approved agent to kill COVID, believe it or not, even pre-COVID. And it's almost amplified more. I work out on my local Planet here in Seabrook, New Hampshire, and people are meticulously cleaning the equipment before and after every use. But, you know, the masks are important. We have touchless check-in. We also have a crowd meter on our app. So before you leave the house, you can determine, do you feel safe or not? You want to wait an extra hour to come in. So, you know, I think the big thing is going to be making sure that clubs are clean, that you're wearing your PPE, and you're wiping stuff down before and after use.
Chris, let's promise that when this is all over, the next interview or a future interview, we'll do it at a Planet Fitness here in New York. You on one with treadmill, me on the other, and we see who falls over first.
Let's do it. Thank you for having me on.
Thank you.